Ever wonder what happened to Fire Lady Ursa? In the official comic book series, The Search, Zuko and Azula must team up to find their long-lost mother. Will they succeed on their quest?
Where is my mother?
In the small Fire Nation village of Hira, young Ursa's gotten the most wonderful news. Her boyfriend, Ikum, has asked her to marry him. And she said yes! But fate has other plans. Fire Lord Azulon showed up with his son Ozai. The Fire Prince had a proposal of his own. As Avatar Roku's granddaughter, Ursa could begin a powerful firebender bloodline by marrying Ozai. She didn't want to, but had no choice. She was forced to sever her connection to Hira, along with her family and Ikum. Fire Lord Zuko had decided it was time to find his long-lost mother. If he wanted to locate Ursa, he'll need Azula's help.
Oh! Stop!
And that isn't going to be easy.
Get back here!
Azula showed Zuko something their father had locked away for years. Before she disappeared, Ursa secretly sent letters to Hira. While it wasn't a huge lead, it was the first one Zuko had in years.
No!
Zuko recruited Team Avatar to accompany him to Hira. There was just one problem. Azula was joining them.
Suki!
Zuko had given his word she wouldn't travel as a prisoner. Of course, it was going to be hard for the team to trust her.
Sokka!
But this was their best shot at finding Ursa. They set off for Hira. And as you probably guessed, it didn't take Azula long before she started sabotaging everything. Get far. During Sozin's comet, Azula had begun to hallucinate her mother, and it's getting worse.
I love you, Azula.
Yeah, boomerang!
Okay?
You don't look so good.
After escaping the wolf spirit, Team Avatar set up camp. Wait, what's that hiding in Azula's boot? One of Ursa's letters? My dearest Ikum, it's taken me a long time to admit it, but you are right. I belong with you and nothing is worth this pain. My only consolation is our son Zuko. When I look into his eyes, it's as if I'm looking into yours. My thoughts are always with you. Love, Ursa. For many years, Ursa had been keeping mementos of her old life. She had never forgotten about Hira or Ikum, and had been secretly writing letters to him. But unbeknownst to Ursa, Ozai had been intercepting the letters, including the one Zuko just read. How was this possible? Could Ikum be Zuko's real father? Ozai ordered a Yuyan archer to track down and assassinate Ikum, but he barely made it back alive. He tracked Ikum to the nearby forest, but after months of searching, he was never found.
can't believe it!
Zuko shared the letter with the Avatar. Something didn't add up. And if Zuko was in fact not Ozai's son, his claim to the throne could be in jeopardy. Wait, that would mean Azula could...
There you are!
It became obvious why Azula kept that letter. She thinks it's her destiny to be Fire Lord. But they will never find Ursa if they keep fighting. They finally made it to Hira. In classic Team Avatar fashion, they threw on some disguises and headed into town. A large group gathered to catch the local theater performance, which looked like a good place to start asking around. Meet Norrin, director of the Hira acting troupe. Ursa used to be a member years ago, so Norrin recognized her name. He brought Team Avatar back to his home, where they met his wife Noriko and their daughter Kiyi. They told Zuko that Ursa left town many years ago. It was rumored that she married into the Fire Nation royal family. As for Ikum, he disappeared shortly after. Some say he went to the Forgotten Valley, an ancient forest outside of town, but neither of them had been seen in years. Zuko felt Ursa getting closer as his final memory of her began to surface.
I'm only telling you for your own good. I know, maybe you could find a nice Earth Kingdom family to adopt you.
Stop it! You're lying! Dad would never do that to me.
Your father would never do what to you? What is going on here?
I don't know.
It's time for a talk.
Azula told Ursa she overheard Azulon. He ordered Ozai to kill Zuko as punishment for betraying Iroh.
She knew I wanted the throne, and she proposed a plan in which I would become Fire Lord, and your life would be spared.
Ursa made a deadly medicine. Ozai used it to poison Azulon in his sleep. Then, to hide his deed and protect himself, he banished Ursa from the capital.
Mom?
Zuko, please, my love, listen to me. Everything I've done to protect you. Remember this, Zuko. No matter how things may seem to change, never forget who you are.
When Team Avatar arrived at the Forgotten Valley, Aang felt a strong spiritual presence. He followed a flutterbat to a small pool. It was clear, peaceful, and tranquil.
Look out!
What's going on? Is the forest attacking them? No, wait. Someone's bending the water in the vines. They introduce themselves as Misu and Rafa, two siblings of the Northern Water Tribe. Several years ago, Rafa's face had been horribly disfigured. Not even the best healers in their tribe could help him. But Misu learned about an ancient spirit. According to the legend, this spirit could give people new faces and could possibly heal Rafa. That legend brought them to the valley, but they've had no luck in finding the mysterious spirit. Aang offered to meditate into the spirit world in order to find her. But Azula nearly ruined everything again.
Whoa!
It's the giant wolf spirit from before, but this time he's not attacking Aang. The Mother of Faces arrived, And she did, in fact, know a woman named Ursa. After Ursa's banishment, she reunited with Ikum. Together, they found the spirit and requested new faces and memories. The spirit had transformed Ikum and Ursa into Norin and Noriko. This was it. With Ursa's identity revealed, Zuko needed to find her before Azula did. Luckily for Zuko, he made it back to Noriko's house with no Azula in sight. Back in the forest, Aang pleaded with the spirit to restore Misu's face. It was taken from him by Ko, the face stealer. Meanwhile in Hira, Zuko revealed his true identity as Fire Lord. But just as Zuko was about to get some answers...
It's over.
Back off, Azula!
Azula fled. The mother faces returned. She offered to restore Noriko's original face and memories, and Noriko accepted. The next morning, Zuko finally reunited with the woman who was truly his mother. With all of her memories back, she told Zuko his father was indeed Ozai. The letter Azula kept was simply an attempt to hurt Ozai, but they both knew the truth. Zuko's claim to the throne was legitimate. Now, Ursa had years of catching up to do with Zuko. That wraps up the search. Which comic book should we recap next? Let us know in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe for all things Avatar.